This episode of How to Spin Yarn has been brought to you by SpinOlution, state-of-the-art spinning wheels proudly made by families in the USA. And by My Local Wool. Find farms, festivals, artisans, and shops near you by visiting mylocalwool.com. Welcome back to Spindling and the tutorial PUFFED. In this tutorial, you'll need to go through your stash and find a fiber to use as your base. I'm going to be using alpaca locks. And I think Sarah's using like a wool roving. Mm-hmm. And then you'll want to find a fiber to use as an accent fiber. These are what we're going to be making puffs out of. So I have a few different things. You could use sparkle, silk, flax, anything, bits of art bat. I have some silk noils, roving, locks. We're just going to play. So this is similar to the thickened technique, except instead of making thick and thin sections from one handful of fiber, we're going to be spinning a single and then kind of core spinning or adding a puff of fiber on top of it and then continuing with our base single. Yeah.
All right.
Cool. I might use this. I'm going to start with top as my base because I want like a smooth base. So we're going to get our smooth okay. I just don't want it to fall apart. This is a little slippery. Okay, so now I'm going to add my like puff pop of texture. So I'm going to try silk noils. We'll just get like a pinch and we'll draft our top up. And I'm just going to make a V and kind of stick them in between. And I'm just going to experiment for now because I don't know exactly. Oh, my top fell apart. Let me get back to that. I feel like I need like a technical difficulties screen, like standby.
Oh, is that it?
Yes!
It's like a little butterfly.
Yes.
I like it.
Woo. Okay, so let's stick the puff of fiber in between. Yeah. There it is.
Yeah. Love.
Make sure you add plenty of twist in this.
The fun part is finding the special piece.
Yes. What's going to be your little puff of happiness? Why is mine falling apart? I'm using the wrong fiber. I'm going to move on to something else.
The wool is working really well.
I wonder if my spindle is too heavy with all the weights on it.
Especially with the slippery, probably.
Yeah. I'm going to move up to my bulky. Actually, I'm going to borrow yours. It's the same size, but it doesn't have any weights.
I'm going to do a butterfly every other park because one butterfly in real life is pretty and too many butterflies freak me out. They do.
Like apocalyptic or something. I like that artistic thing. the reasoning behind it is great. Yeah, I think my spindle was too heavy before. So if you get into a vibe where you're spinning, but it's like your yarn is kind of pulling apart in a weird way, it might be that your spindle is too heavy. So what I could have done is I could have just made like a much bulkier yarn on that spindle, like out of blocks or something. But I didn't want to do that. I wanted to do a nice thin base and then an exaggerated puff. Okay, so here's my base. Now I'm going to do a sparkle puff, and I'm actually going to do this the way that I did on the wheel, where I wrap the sparkle rather than splitting the fiber. I wrap the sparkle around like this. This is actually technically how you're supposed to do it.
Oh!
But, there you but. I'm not going to sell this, by the way, so don't be too grossed out. Okay, so that technically, having that sparkle wrapped around the yarn, technically, that's what we're doing. But I still like the butterflies.
I do too.
Like, yeah. So, bonus. Actually, I've never done the butterfly thing before. I think that's a totally brand new thing.
I invented something.
You invent. What do you want to call it?
Oh, I don't know.
Think about it.
Yeah.
Because I don't know what you're doing, but you're getting like super artsy and you're gonna put me out of business. You're my get out of here! Get out of here! You're my competition now, man.
I'm out.
You can call them flutterbys.
I like it. You could put like cocoons in it.
Yes. She's getting so creative. Okay, so now I'm gonna take some of these silk noils and I'm gonna wrap those around my yarn. It's tough because there they go. You want them to go at like a 90 degree angle and get plenty of twist. On a wheel, you can definitely make this more secure. So I'm not totally, totally sold on this yet, but that's how you do it.
That looks so neat.
Yeah, it's like a ball, like a
yeah.
Pom-pom.
Mm-hmm. Yes, yeah.
But lots and lots of twist is key. And it's not, like, it's not feeling to me super secure. So if you're totally in love with this technique, some ways to make it secure are you could bring a thread wrap with it, like our tutorial wrapped. And when you make your poof, you can wrap your thread around it so that you can't, like, pull it off as easily. You can ply it using one of the ply techniques in this series. And you can knot it, which is what we're doing next.
Oh, I'm excited for that one.
Yeah. Make sure you have plenty of twist in your single. So I did a sparkle poof, a silk noil poof, and now I'm going to do a poof of locks. This fiber. It wants to break up with me. Okay, so here's I want you to do a butterfly of locks.
Oh, yes.
So here's the locks I have. I'm going to fluff them up a little bit. And I don't have too much twist in this single because I know I'm going to have to add a lot more twist to get the locks to secure. And I also don't want this single to become over twisted and like gnarly and hard. So I'm going to take my locks, pinch them to the single so that they begin to wrap around at a 90 degree angle. And now this is really over twisted, so I'll take the twist out and draft up. And yeah, that's pretty secure. This one feels more secure than the little silk noils did. And the silk noils are basically tiny, tiny little like cotton ball looking things of silk. So since they are so tiny and they're not really connected, they're probably not the best thing to make poofs out of, but they look cute. But it'd be easy to just kind of like pull them apart.
It's interesting how different each one looks.
Yes. You can make poofs out of anything. I think next I'll do, well, the only thing I've had trouble making poofs out of is silk because it's like really slippery and like falls off. Locks are very easy. Art bats are very easy.
Oh, it's cute.
That's really cute. Locks. Yes. I like the locks too. I think the locks is my favorite. I'm going to make a poof out of some top. So I'm going to grab some of this top from Busy Bee Fibers on Etsy and kind of pull it apart to make the staple length all the same and wrap it around just like that. Here, maybe if I pinch. There we go. You really have to sculpt it. See how I'm holding my hands? It's very sculptural. There we go. And now the very tip, the fluffy tip of that, I'm going to kind of draft up with my base, and you can see that it's secured like that. So I kind of had to twist and mold and secure it on at a 90 degree angle, and then I up here twisted it with my base fiber to secure it, and it's really, really secure. And in your empty sections, do make sure you add a lot of twist, because when you take this off, if this section of your base doesn't have a lot of twist in it, that the twist will kind of balance out throughout the entire yardage when you take it off your spindle. And if there's any looseness, it can affect your poofs and make them less stable. How's it going?
Pretty good. Last of the locks.
That's really cute. You should show that. That's my favorite one that you've done. That is incredible. Here, I'll show mine too. So bring it like
oh, there we go. Okay.
So now you can see like the textures and the base. Very, very cute.
That's interesting.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Super fun. Yeah, that was fun.
That was fun. I think that was my favorite.
Yeah. You looked like you had a lot of fun with mm-hmm. that. So yeah, two different techniques. You can tuck your poofs in between your top or your roving and just kind of like lock it in and twist it around. You can also do that same technique with yarn scraps and make like a fringe. Mm-hmm. Or you can wrap it around at a 90-degree angle like core spinning and secure it that way. Mm-hmm. And that's the end of puffed, poofed, whatever we're calling this, puffed.
Perfect.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Thank you for watching and happy spindling.